Story 1. I'll start by saying that my wife had an affair with her boss at work 3 years ago. I remember the day down to the second when I found out what was happening. With that said, I will also add that I am a combat veteran with 19 years of service and 6 plus years in combat zones. The trauma from war pales in comparison to dealing with my wife's affair. I was prepared, somewhat, for war. I went through it with friends. I knew that no matter how bad things got, I'd either be gone or I'd have people there to go through the terrible with me. Even once I got back, talking about my experiences to friends or therapist is no issue. Dealing with my wife's affair has been about as opposite of that as things can get. It has been completely isolating. I can't talk about it with family or friends. For one, they'd wonder why I'm still with her and how someone who is so outwardly strong and successful as I am would stick around after her affair. Next is the fact that it's completely emasculating. The entire experience made me feel lower than whale dung at the bottom of the ocean. Next is that I'm just sad all the time now. The person who was my rock for so long, the person that I trusted with my deepest, darkest secrets, the person that was the stability that I needed to be successful and honestly to stay alive in combat, deceived me. Not just deceived me, but betrayed my trust in the worst possible way imaginable. In the past, when I was at my lowest points in life, my confidant was my wife. Now, she is the person that has caused me to be at my lowest point, and she is the person I want to talk to. But I can't. Because she is the one that caused this to begin with. I know I'm just ranting now, but I'd spend the rest of my life in combat to not have to deal with the torture of my wife cheating. I can unequivocally say that this is the worst thing that has ever happened to me in my life. I know I should just get over it and move on, but I don't know how. I'm not a crier, but I lay awake at nights with tears rolling down my face, and there's no one I can tell. No one I can talk to. It's honestly a miserable existence. I'm sorry. We have been there. This is a place you can talk. I hated the fact I couldn't go to my wife with the pain as well. It's such a mind duck. The support person being the cause. Ugh. Finding this sub has been life-changing for me. I also felt like I had no one to talk to. At least here people understand. We absolutely believe how bad this hurts and all the life-changing complexity that comes with that pain. I'm not really a crier either. When I found out, I cried and made horrible sounds I've never heard from myself or anyone before. After all this time, I don't really cry anymore about anything and probably never will. Hang in there, brother, and thank you for your service. Add no one to talk to. At least here people understand. We absolutely believe how bad this hurts and all the life-changing. Yay. It has numbed me in a way I didn't know was possible. Maybe this is a transition that everyone goes through in life. I don't know. I just know I was a lot happier and able to actually have feelings before. 3 tours here. I was a fobbit, so no street cred. Although I did get yelled at when I got in an MRAP during a combined VEED ground attack. Long story, you do need to talk with somebody. Unit chaplain, fellow members of your unit with whom you were deployed, somebody. I'd wager you're not the only one going through this, although they might be silent about it as well, or not, want to, no, you should also speak to a non-military lawyer regarding your rights vis-a-vis divorce and a post-nuptial agreement if you remain together. There is no harm in individual counseling. TRICARE might cover that, I don't know. Now, this is going to seem harsh, but you need to hear this. Apologies in advance, never discount the possibility that this was not her only affair. 1. Cheaters only admit to what they think you know. This is known as trickle truth. 2. Paternity test your kids. If you have any. I'm not trying to plant seeds, but you need to be sure. 3. Marriage counseling. Be forewarned. You may find out more than you wish. Good luck, fellow soldier. Keep us posted. Truth is truth, and I appreciate you for it. As far as this being her only affair, I don't know. Looking back, it's very likely that she cheated when I was deployed. With that said, there were no indications that she cheated like there were this time. I've thought about this as well. On one hand, I doubt she'll just come out and admit it if it did happen. Not without any evidence. Also, I don't know what good there is in me searching and finding out. I guess I want to look forward and to make sure it doesn't happen again. If it does happen again, well then our relationship is done. As far as our kids, I'm certain they are mine. Just type the below elsewhere. So just pasting here, I did counseling when I first found out. But that's it. I tried two different counselors and they were both very religious, of which I am not, so their approach and their recommendations about prayer didn't work for me. 2, I don't want to admit to my wife that this is still an issue. Don't want her to know how damaged I am and how much pain I am still in 3 years later. Before the affair, I would have told her that I had an issue that I needed help with and that I thought I needed counseling. Now, I can't trust her with something so deep and personal. Story 2, me, female 29, and my husband, male 35, have been together for 5 years, married 4, and we have 2 daughters, 2.5 years old and 8 months. The first 9 months of our relationship were long distance as I lived in the UK and he lived in the US. I moved to the US to be with him, and 2 weeks after getting married I found out he cheated on me 3 times, with 2 different women, while we were still long distance. He also had been talking to his ex-girlfriend and I found out other unpleasant things he had been doing / saying. We talked it over and he explained that what he did was purely physical as he had a need for sex since we couldn't see each other very often. Over the next few months he did his best to regain my trust. He was understanding and patient with me as I went through the emotional roller coaster that being cheated on is. We decided to stay together and nothing strange or suspicious ever happened again. He's a very loving partner, sometimes almost too loving, as I'm very independent and like my own space, who shows me his love and devotion every day. With our first child he wasn't very helpful, but he was still very loving towards me and the baby. Our relationship was still pretty strong, but he started being unhappy with his job. He had an amazing job, well paid, and doing exactly what he studied for, and he began being moody every single day. Weekends were better, but he always refused to do anything other than staying home and he would use the with the baby as stressful excuse for everything. We moved to my home country about 1.5 years ago and got pregnant with our second baby. We found jobs we both liked and he quickly started growing tired of his new job too, which seems to be a running issue in his life, according to his friends, as he admittedly wishes he didn't have to work, don't we all? We're very happy here, life isn't as chaotic as it was in NYC, we live near the beach, we are financially stable and have a great life, but over the past year I've literally felt myself grow further and further away from him. I'm a dynamic, active person, someone who likes to get out and walk, I love being busy and doing things, but he's again, constantly forcing us to stay inside or telling me to just take the kids and go out if I want to, which results in no quality time as a family, plus he gets all the free time when we're not around. He also doesn't acknowledge any traditions such as my birthdays, the baby's birthdays, anniversaries, Christmas, etc., so we're unable to make memories as a family since all of these occasions mean nothing to him and he makes an effort to make them extra bad when they arise. Recently, I reconnected with someone from my past, who I've never dated, but we've always been mutually interested in one another, and the conversations I've been having with him made me realize that I might be forcing happiness into my marriage. I'm in no way thinking of cheating, I'd never do this to him, but I've been feeling like I deserve a lot more. My husband loves me to bits, but he's not willing to grow out of his child phase, which was cute in the beginning, but has now become a huge turnoff for me. My friends, who have zero against my husband but also know how he can be, recently talked to me about the idea of separation. I can't lie, I had been thinking about what life would be like if we separated, but I'm so afraid. I'm afraid I'll mess my kids up, and moreover I'm not entirely sure I want to do this to him. I know I love him, but I don't know if I'm in love with him anymore, and I can't make up my mind as I don't want to hurt him but also feel deeply unhappy and frustrated. I guess I'm looking for answers from people who are or have been in my situation. I feel like I'm trying to change him, which I know I can't. So in my position, would you stay or would you go? How have you communicated to him that his behaviors are starting to create these thoughts? Have you communicated openly and honestly how he is hurting you? Or will it blindside him? If you've communicated and no change has happened, then it's on him. But if you haven't, then I would at least try honest communication first. Your husband is depressed. That is clear. He likely needs clinical help for his untreated depression. We have communicated clearly about these issues, I always voiced my grievances and nothing has ever changed. Which is what has contributed to me having these thoughts. I tried to discuss with him the possibility of going to therapy as I also believe that he might be depressed, but he keeps saying he's happy, he just wishes he didn't have to work. Believe me, it's been years of back and forth. You owe it to your family to stay until all remedies for the problems in your marriage are exhausted. Curious how reconnecting with that old friend made you realize that you were forcing happiness into your marriage. As for other people suggesting that you separate, you need to establish better boundaries for outsiders. Those people have no business making that suggestion, and in doing so, are being toxic to your family. How much consideration for your children's home life do your friends have? As for your husband, the past indiscretions are a problem, but that does not seem to be the issue. You two seem to be good candidates for marriage counseling if the willingness to stay married is present. However, if you have already decided you don't want to try, then just come out and say that it's you, not friends or other people or your husband, who wants the marriage to end. The people who have suggested separation are extremely close to me and have witnessed my husband's demeanor towards me and our overall relationship for years. Their insight is welcome for me. My family is my priority, but I'm an individual who's worthy of happiness. My needs aren't being met by someone who made mistakes which could have ended our relationship if it hadn't been for my willingness to stay. My reconnection with my friend made me realize that I'm indeed worthy of feeling appreciated, and that I shouldn't settle for someone who isn't only a passive participant in our relationship. You are married to your husband and they are not. What insight could they possibly have into your private life that gives them the privilege to suggest breaking up your marriage? Your family is your priority, is it? Then you agree marriage counseling is the best option. That way you can effectively communicate your needs and resolve the past grievance. Sorry, this last part screams emotional affair, if not nearing physical affair. If you want to save your marriage and yourself from years of regret, cut contact with this person. You both know you are married and you are playing footsie under the table. Have you disclosed this old friend and the things that you've said to your husband and other friends? If you can't, then it's an affair. My husband knows about my communication with this friend and my friend knows about my situation. Things never got romantic between us. We simply had conversations that related to our relationships, in which both of us are having issues. I'm not having an emotional affair, let alone a physical one. My friend simply brought up a thought that I already had and was too afraid to voice. On top of that, they have experienced the sorrow I went through due to my husband's lack of involvement in our relationship and his past infidelity. My last resort is separation, but I've been questioning my feelings lately. I'm getting a lot of judgmental vibes from you, and I understand if this isn't your intention, but yes, my family absolutely is my first priority, and yes, marriage counseling may be an option, but he has refused time and time again because he says that everything is fine on his end. Mine is just one man's opinion. Try harder for marriage counseling is my advice. Worldwide comments of the day. Wife cheats on husband, wife most affected. Me and me. The first story was unbearably narcissistic. Just while you broke the dude's heart and you're here just crying about how you feel. Once you cheat, it's over, in my opinion, no rebuilding. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more interesting and relatable Reddit videos.